the Canadian guidelines recommend that all pregnant women be screened for gestational diabetes between 24 and 28 weeks gestation. However, if a woman has additional risk factors for type 2 diabetes, such as a previous history of gestational diabetes, strong family history of type 2 diabetes or overweight or obesity, then it's recommended that they may be screened earlier in pregnancy. And the main reason for that is to make sure they don't have type 2 diabetes, which would show up right away. Generally, what you eat leading up to the test for gestational diabetes does not have an effect on the results of the test. We recommend for the first glucose screening test that women don't need to fast, and that we're just interested in knowing what happens to their blood sugar after we give them a large glucose drink. Having said that, though, if a woman decides to also have a large carb or sweet snack prior, just before taking the test, that could likely increase the blood sugar result further. But earlier in the pregnancy, the results should not, whatever they eat early in the pregnancy should not have a substantial effect on the actual test results. Being diagnosed with gestational diabetes can be very stressful for women, because pregnancy is supposed to be a hopeful time, a time of anticipation and a happy time for women. And then they get this diagnosis, which has implications for both them and the baby. So we definitely know that it can make women feel somewhat negative about the pregnancy and anxious about what it means for them and their baby. However, we know that here in Canada, we have really great diabetes teams that are able to help women manage their diabetes and make it as convenient as possible for them, so the pregnancy is not, so that they have a better experience. So they, for example, they do need to have some extra appointments, and they do need to check their blood sugars during pregnancy several times a day, and they do need to make modifications to their diet. But with those changes, they're actually, their chances of having a healthy pregnancy are very high. So if gestational diabetes is not well controlled and the blood sugars are high, then there is a higher risk that the baby will overgrow. Overgrowth of the baby can lead to large-sized babies, and that can lead to birth complications. Those birth complications can include prematurity and early delivery, can increase risk of need for C-section, and if a woman does undergo a vaginal delivery, then that can increase the risk of birth trauma and complications of labor. So a lot of women, once they're diagnosed with gestational diabetes and they start testing their blood sugars and start seeing how what they eat is affecting the blood sugars, they ask us whether cutting out the carbs in their diet is a good way of actually keeping those blood sugars normal. And what we tell them is that while cutting out carbs does keep your blood sugars low, it's at the expense of the health of your baby. So we know that when with very low carb diets, we make ketones, and those ketones have been shown to have adverse effects on the baby. And so for that reason, we actually don't recommend that women cut out their carbs completely in pregnancy. We recommend that they have a healthy amount of carbs and that they spread them throughout the day, and that they choose carbs that are healthier for them, lower glycemic index, complex carbohydrates, as opposed to high glycemic index, simple carbohydrates.